Do as you promised, that your name will be great forever. 1 Chronicles chapter 17, verses 23 to 24. This is one of the most blessed aspects of genuine prayer. Often, we ask for things that God has not specifically promised. Therefore, we are not sure if our petitions are in line with His purpose until we have persevered for some time in prayer. Yet, on some occasions, we are fully persuaded that what we are asking is in accordance with God's will. We feel led to select and plead a promise from the pages of Scripture, having been specifically and specially impressed that it contains a message for us. At these times, we may say with confident faith, "Do as you promised." Every promise of Scripture is a letter from God, which we may plead before Him with His reasonable request, "Do as you promised." Our Creator will never cheat those of us of His creation who depend upon His truth. And even more, our Heavenly Father will never break His word to His own child. "Remember your word to your servant, for you have given me hope." This is a very common plea and is a double argument, for it is your word. Will you keep it? Will you not keep it? Why have you spoken it if you will not make it good? You have given me hope. Will you now disappoint the hope that you yourself have brought forth within me? Wrote Charles Head Spurgeon. Being fully persuaded that God had power to do what He had promised is Abraham kind of faith. It is the everlasting faithfulness of God that makes a Bible promise very great and precious. Human promises are often worthless, and many broken promises have left broken hearts. But since the creation of the world, God has never broken a single promise to one of His trusting children. Oh, how sad it is for a poor Christian to stand at the very door of a promise during a dark night of affliction, being afraid to turn the knob and thereby come boldly into the shelter as a child. Every promise of God is built on four pillars. The first two are His justice and holiness, which will never allow Him to deceive us. The third is His grace or goodness, which will not allow Him to forget. And the fourth is His truth, which will not allow Him to change, which enables Him to accomplish what He has promised. Do as you promised, that your name will be great forever. 1 Chronicles chapter 17, verses 23 to 24.